Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Wybot. Welcome back to Civilization 6. So we're winding down our war with Gilgamesh here. We only have 4 more cities to take, and they don't look like they're going to put up much of a fight. So I was taking a look at some of the new lenses that come along with this game. Let's try lenses that come along with the enhanced UI mod. So, anyway. This right here is the city overlap screen, which I've been ignoring city overlap strategies because they took out very quickly within, like, the first or second patch. They took out the industrial zone stacking, which really, that probably was for the best, but it still kind of stings a little bit. So anyway, well, for starters, I think I kind of buggered it up in Jakarta here. Yeah, I did, in fact. So this is our industrial zone in Jakarta. It's okay. It has, it'll support Rockhampton, it'll support Melbourne, it'll support Leventa. This one will only support Melbourne and Rockhampton. Actually, it doesn't really matter because, yeah, Melbourne would have access to 2. But I'm thinking about entertainment squares, and I think I may have to drop one right here just to kind of generate some happiness for these 3 cities right here. And then looks like there's some really golden opportunities right here over at Kish. This actually goes down to, there are a total of 7 cities within range of this tile, so we definitely need to make sure that this city gets up and running. I'm gonna send lots of internal trade routes from here to get its production way up and running. Also make sure that we get everything improved here, get some good adjacency bonuses. And then also here, this is 6 cities will benefit from, say, an entertainment square or an industrial district around here. So, something to consider. Especially Newcastle. It doesn't have access to any industrial district bonuses yet, and it's a powerhouse of a city, so we want to look into that. So, it's something to consider. More specifically for Alright, so we got a theming bonus going on here so far. More specifically, we're considering that for entertainment squares, really, because I'm having some amenity problems. We're running short on them, so I want to see what we can do there. Alright, so let's continue on with the game. Gilgamesh is trying to make peace again. Okay, Gilgamesh. So he probably will give me an unconditional surrender. Except for the city of Ur. Nope. Sorry. Okay, so let's keep things moving here. India's trading with the Aztecs, so they must have peaced out. Yeah, they peaced out with the Aztecs. That's unfortunate. What can we build here? We don't have enough population for an entertainment complex. Start working on a builder very slowly, I guess. this guy not have the expert crew promotion? No. Well, yes, they do, but there's nothing within range. Fine. Alright, you lot up to the front. Same with you, up you go. Damn, that sucks. So there's horses here that I could get the bonuses for Outback stations, but there's nothing good. What's this right here? This is grassland bordering on tundra, so when we grab that tile, when we take this city, we can do something about it. So, you actually move over here for now. Hope you don't get captured. Actually move you down here to protect them. Sure, seems like a good plan. Move over to Broadway. There's not much going on there. You guys have a promotion. Let's go ahead and take the promotion. Get a boost versus anti-cavalry? Sure, why not? Let's go up here and make sure that we've met all the city-states. And let's actually send that guy over here just to make sure that we're getting some
Great God of the Ants.
My goodness.
Thou hast let the victory prevail. I hereby name thee the Colonel.
That is extremely distracting. I want to make sure that we have a variety of artifacts in our museums so that we just don't have all the same ones. Don't want to have to muck about with switching things around. Let's repair that. Oh, sorry guys. Smack the apostle. Actually, we have some faith, so let's, an ice in here, let's go ahead and grab some more apostles. And we'll have combustion in a turn or two, so let's move this guy back to our territory, so we can do an upgrade. We're really going to need that new form of government with more policy slots pretty soon. Although we have a trade route we're not using. Four turns till mobilization is done. Victoria's denouncing us. That's fine. She may be next on our shit list. She just might be. Yeah, they seem vulnerable. We could probably take them. Alright, Leventa. You guys can build a trader in 6 turns. Let's do that. Nagoya. Aerodrome. We don't have enough population, unfortunately. I guess build a digger? Sure. Seems good. Zanzibar. Let's start repairing that shrine. Attack with the battering ram. Let's move these guys over, and they can attack with the battering ram as well. What sort of promotions can we give these guys? Martyr, very good. Let's go get him killed by something. And I think we just took that city. Yeah, I believe we just did. Cool. That was incredibly easy. And I suppose the, yeah, you can't capture the naturalist. Damn. That's too bad. Three turns till mobilization is complete. Purchase a unit with faith. Not anything good, though. Fortify till you're healed. Let's get that worker building. Let's move down here and prepare our assault on Ur. Move you on over. You've already moved this turn. You can just walk right in, apparently. Yeah, sure, let's do that. Why not? And for Nippur, we're gonna go ahead and mine the Niter. Through the jungle. Let's have you rest and repair. Have you skip your turn, and that's gonna be it for this turn. Get you out there. Can't occupy that square because India's being a pain in my backside. Well, start building up back stations. This entire area is ripe to be covered in them. So it's a 6-pop city, it only has one. Only has one district. No, two districts. I lied. It's not bad. It's got some promise. Actually, no, it doesn't. It's terrible. It's a pretty poor city. Although we might be able to get some good districts here. Yeah, it's got some good appeal on the crappy tundra tiles.
Cars haven't advanced that much since we were kids. When you boil it.
Oh, I should probably check the. Should probably check what we got out of that. Plus one movement speed for embarked units. Alright, let's start on radio. Get aluminum too, nice. Aerodrome in Newcastle, that sounds kind of promising. Where could we put that? Suppose we could put it right here. Is there any place where it would be of more value? So that's just charming appeal. You know what? Sure, let's drop a aerodrome right here. It'll allow us to build aircraft and allow us to get additional production. And this area right here, we don't have quite enough faith yet, although we're producing 100 per turn, which is very nice. Did we lose our missionary? No, we did not. Okay. So actually just gonna smack that guy around. Okay, and what do we got here? So that's just a minor victory. Let's attack those guys. Can we actually finish that one off? We could, but we might pay for it. Let's try. I'm curious about the religious lens now. Let's see what sort of impact that had. We might be able to flip Kish back. Not that it really matters. And the city continues to have no production. Let's get some builders, some more builders out. Just keep building builders. Get a granary, because that city's getting close to housing cap. This one's fine for now, so... yeah, start working on the watermill. That'll help with production. This just has a encampment district, that's about it. Bad Tibra has three districts, by the looks of it. Although this could belong to Inrindu, I don't think it does though. Alright, so they haven't moved. These little buggers. Well, I might as well upgrade them, and then we can decide what we want to do with them. This is still just a minor victory. Now let's... New. Alright, so next turn that city falls. Actually, no, this turn that city falls. Because these guys can attack again. Perfect. Alright, Urizars. Oh, and the Great Lighthouse is here. I did not see that. Perfect. Warmonger penalty is now light. Oh, man. They've just given up on hating us. And these guys can just keep going. That's great. Alright, so keep you guys there for a couple more turns. Maybe move you up one. You can't attack. I'm not putting you in between the city, though. Oh, whoop! Derp! Alright. Trying to use workers to attack. Not the best strategy. No. And these guys are going to take a frickin' fortune to upgrade, so that's not too great. Alright, so Nagoya. Trade route from Nagoya. We did Newcastle last time? What do we have here in terms of options? Newcastle it is. I thought we were making money. Now it's saying we're not. All right, you guys stay there for now. Just chill. Oh, what probably happened is the harbors, this city's buildings came into our calculations, and now we're losing money again. Anyway, our field cannon. Let's move them up. Now we can cycle our turns. And no, we're not willing to peace out with you now, Gilgamesh. We might as well just end you. Or let you keep this crappy little city. They want everything for oranges and one gold. I got a better idea. How about you go fuck yourselves? I got something there. Oh, great persons. Six turns away for Monty. We're a long ways off. Did we want to try? How long is a research project? Six turns. So I think we've already lost it. So there's probably no point. Alright, I guess he gets that. That sucks. You do the same. And chill there. All right, you guys build an Outback station or not. Right, clear the marsh. You guys get in there. You guys head in that direction. Alright, and big surprise, we can't capture the naturalist. They just probably got punted to this city over here. You guys get moved back. This guy's going on a little adventure. Alright. And you. We have one more improvement action. I say go improve that mine. You guys should probably be here-ish. Actually, I'll move you here. We'll start building up back stations. Alright, next turn. Oh, he's finally arrived. Perfect. Alright, choose our artifact. Let's choose mystery artifact. Cool. Got a boost for cultural heritage. And javelin created by somebody, but it's themed. Perfect. So, cultural victory, where does that put us? Dead last. Interesting that it's still dead last. I would question that. Oh well, we'll see. So mobilization next turn. So we can get our units combined into armies now and be even more effective.
Our military is now trained in the...
When they are preparing for war, those...
Alright, so levée en masse is gone. We're going to drop... Or rather, conscription is gone, and now it's time for levée en masse. Alright, there we go. Now, what do we want? Let's get started on mass media. Canterbury. Could really use a stock exchange. Use a trader more, though, so that's top priority. Levé en masse has got us back in the black, which is nice. These guys, I believe they can actually fire on Bad Tibra. Yep. Perfect. Let's get you guys up here, and let's form an army. So we've got a digger army here that has 89 combat strength. So that's the raw number, because they will have bonus. Let's just review the digger here. Igger? Yeah? Wow. Right! I remember, I inverted my keyboard. Right, so the digger. Plus 10 combat strength when fighting on coastal tiles, and plus 5 when in foreign or neutral territory. I wonder how that scales with the armies. Let's see what happens if we attack. So you just build another outback station. Only getting plus 1 production. Oh right, they have to be they have to have adjacency to get the bonus. But then they all get the bonus, which is good. Alright, so you lot, get up there please. You guys get over there. You guys move up to the encampment. Yeah. And keep firing. Cannon, keep moving up. I had a really good cannon. Was it this one? No. Where is... So this is... one of the really good cannons. So move him up here onto the plains. Another outback station. There goes the timer. So we'll go for a turn or two after this. Two cities need food. Jakarta is... stagnant. And Nippur is also stagnant. Well, we can fix that. Build a farm here. And there be the Aztecs. Alright. And there be the Pussycat. Alright, so one more turn then. Angus, get away from the cord. Let's see what I can do with a cat on my mouse hand. Alright. So, blast that, blast that. Move our digger army up. Move our artillery up. We'll get this army set up right here. Apparently this apostle, yeah, let's actually go ahead and sack that apostle. And then we can do the same thing with this one, too. We'll see what that does to us. And apparently we flipped over Newcastle upon Thine by accident. And England is sore because they have their own religion, I believe. Alright, so we'll go ahead and start working on a builder in Nippur. Hopefully things will go faster once we just take all Gilgamesh's stuff. Alright, choose production over an Ur. Well, we definitely don't need a granary yet. It's getting Australia's bonus for being on the coast. Let's get a worker. Move this dude up. And we can take a shot at Bad Tibra. Actually, we can just move this guy right up to Bad Tibra and take a shot as well. Or not. Out of movement points, that's fine. So Nagoya to Delhi was the last trade route here. That seems fairly decent. Sure, let's continue that. Keep relations going good with Gandhi. Move these guys up here, we'll chop that. Actually, we still need to get some stuff sorted here. Also, let's see if we can do some damage here against the anti-tank. No, that'll probably just get our dude killed. Whoops. Yeah, this isn't looking so good. Let's leave. Just a sec, guys. I gotta put the cat back down. He won't stay down, but, you know, he needs to get away from the cords. He just can't help himself. Poor little guy. Gilgamesh wants to make peace. I think we'll just see if we can maybe end this on taking Bad Tibra. And if we can do that in this turn. If we can't, then that's too bad. But I think we can pull that off. Also, the cat buggered off, so. Oh! Oh, isn't that convenient? Nice. So we got ourselves a relic out of that death. And as I kind of guessed, the barbarian anti-tank went and just killed her dude. That's unfortunate. These guys would get murdered if we try to do anything against the Indian apostles. Alright. Can move him over. We can core these guys up. That's our battering ram. Okay. Alright, Gilgamesh has taken a bit of a beating there. And that's a decisive victory right there, folks. It's 102. Let's take a look at the modifiers. Oh, it's still just plus 10 combat. Okay, plus 5 combat strength outside of... Alright, so that does not stack because they're an army. still an important determining factor. Because making their effective combat strength that high means that they could potentially hold their own against these guys. Let's actually look at mechanized infantry. Mechanized infantry. They are 85 combat strength, so these guys are like 89, so an army of these guys will win against mechanized infantry. Well, we'll give it a try later. I mean, we're gonna produce a crap ton of them. We'll keep that city, we'll keep Bad Tibra. We'll start producing stuff. Like a stock exchange. And a military academy. Do we want a neighborhood? Is there any point in a neighborhood? Plus 3 housing, that's hardly worth it. Plus 4 housing on the Tundra Hills. Yeah, it doesn't really seem worth it to get a neighborhood here. My apologies, folks. Hang on a sec. Alright, and I'm back. Scammy telemarketers are scammy. Alright, I think we're going to wrap this one up, folks. Gonna maybe play with the cat for a bit. Get some of his mischievous cord-chewing energy out of his system. And here, let's get that mine built. And Gilgamesh is down to just the one city. Those dudes go. Cantabera, let's make this a food trade route here. So, yeah, we're just going to finish off this turn, and that'll be it for this particular episode. Like I said, cat needs play. Clear the woods. We got another worker out of it. And that means we have opportunities to build more things. What sort of things would we like to build? Possibly an art museum. If we can faith buy. And what else would we like to build? Can't build a tank here. Diggers are impractical to build. Guess we got a water mill. That'll help improve the yields of the rice. That's very good. You guys just stay there for now. And you guys might as well just head on in that direction. And improve this rice. Got quite a bit of rice going on here. Perfect. Alright guys, that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you're enjoying these videos. I'm going to check on the science rankings. Awesome. Well, we're doing a lot better, but once again, Monty, who... I kind of think this guy needs to get the Nerf hammer kind of slammed in his face when it comes to the science victory, because he's a little bit out of control, I'll be honest. He's kind of the bane of my existence. I kind of think I might actually take him out of the next Let's Play I do. Because I don't want him sitting around mucking about with science victories. But then again, my failure, or his success, is my failure, so it's going to be something we have to learn from here. Myself and anybody else who's having problems with this little bastard. Like, the obvious decision, the obvious way to win is to simply just run him over with your military. But he is so far ahead right now that that's not really an option, and he's also on the other side of the map. So anyway, he's got two more things to build. One thing they do actually need to nerf is the amount of freaking launch sites that these guys build, because it's ridiculous. We've got... This is something I've noticed, and it's very irritating. So, 1, 2, 3. And by the way, the Fog of War no longer tells you what's going on, because this is... This right here is, that's the Apollo program right there. So, that is the third launch site. It's number 4. Oh, come on, Monty. I know you got more than that hiding around here. Or does he? Do you only have 4? Nope, 5. Somehow he built one in a 3-pop city. Yep. Is it only 5 he has today? Monty, I'm disappointed. I'm used to you having like 7 of the bloody things. Alright, well, that's going to do it for this particular episode, folks. Thank you very much for watching. Yeah, I'm sorry if I'm a little bit bitter about Monty's obsession with the space race victory. He really should be tuned for domination based on his personality, but whatever. So that's going to do it for this episode, folks. I guess if he wasn't tuned for it, somebody else would. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying these videos. We'll continue to do what we can to stop Mr. Montezuma here. Although I'm going to be really damn salty if he wins before turn 300 here. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.